Radians or degrees. When working with sine, cosine, and tangents of angles, you need to determine in the problem if you'll be working in radians or degrees. Then you need to set your calculator's mode to radians or degrees. Currently, my TI-84 Plus CE is set to radian mode. You can see that here at the top of the calculator's monitor, where it says radian. How do you know if you should be in radian mode or degree mode? If the problem says radians, or has pi symbol in the problem like this, cosine of 5 pi divided by 2, or if the problem does not have neither the degree symbol nor the pi symbol, then use radians. When do you use the degree mode? If your problem says degrees or has the degree symbol, then you need to change the calculator to degree mode. For example, in this problem, what is the sine of 90 degrees? You need to be in degree mode to calculate this problem. How do we change the calculator to degree mode or to radian mode? Press the mode button here. This window pops up. Then down here it says radian degree. Move the blinking cursor to that spot. Then use the right arrow button to move the blinking cursor to degree. And then press the enter button here. Now you see at the top of the calculator monitor, it now states degree. To get out of this mode window, press the second button here and then the mode button here, which is also used as the quit button. Now we're back at the home screen. And at the top of the monitor, you can see we are in degree mode. We will start with some simple problems. What is the sine of 90 degrees? Press the sine button here. Enter 90 and close the parentheses by pressing this button here. We are already in degree mode on the calculator. Now press the enter button here to get the answer. The answer is 1. Now let's find the cosine of 90 degrees. Press the cosine button here. Enter 90. Close the parentheses. And hit the enter button. And the answer is 0. Let's find the tangent of 90 degrees. Press the tangent button here. Enter 90. Close the parentheses. And hit the enter button. And we get this error message. We did not do anything wrong. It is just the tangent is not defined at 90 degrees. To escape this error message, press the enter button. Remember, the tangent of something, x, is equal to the sine of x divided by the cosine of x. So, the tangent of 90 degrees is equal to sine 90 degrees over the cosine of 90 degrees. The sine of 90 degrees is 1, and the cosine of 90 degrees is 0. So anytime we have a 0 in the denominator, it is undefined. That is why we got that error message for trying to take the tangent of 90 degrees. Let's look at inverse sine, inverse cosine, and inverse tangent. The inverse sine is also called arc sine. The inverse cosine is also called arc cosine. And the inverse tangent is also called arc tangent. So to inverse something, we go back or go in reverse or go in the opposite direction. So if we start with this 1 and go back, we should get 90. And that is the inverse sine or arc sine. To take the arc sine of 1, if you look just above the sine, cosine, tangent buttons, you see in blue, sine to the negative 1, cosine to the negative 1, and tangent to the negative 1. Those are the inverses. To find the arc sine of 1, press the second button here, press the sine button here, enter a 1, close the parentheses, and press the enter button. And we get 90 as our answer. The arc sine or inverse sine of 1 is 90 degrees. Okay, we will now do a right triangle problem. Clear the calculator screen by pressing the clear button here. We have this right triangle here. The angle on top is 35 degrees. Thus, we are working in degrees, and we need to make sure that the calculator is in degree mode. The left side of the triangle is 6 inches long. We want to find the length of the hypotenuse. That is all the information we are given. The first step is to use SOHCAHTOA. We are looking for the length of the hypotenuse. We know the length of one of the side adjacent to the 35-degree angle. Thus, we want to use CA. Cosine of 35 degrees equals the side length of the adjacent angle over the length of the hypotenuse. The length of the adjacent side is 6 inches. So our equation is the cosine of 35 degrees equals 6 inches divided by the length of the hypotenuse. So we need to find the cosine of 35 degrees. Press the cosine button here. Enter 35. Close the parentheses. Press Enter. The cosine of 35 degrees is 0.8192. Now the equation becomes 0.8192 equals 6 inches divided by the hypotenuse. Using algebra, we arrange the equation and now have the hypotenuse equals 6 inches divided by 0.8192. 6 inches divided by 0.8192 equals 7.32. Thus, the hypotenuse equals 7.32 inches. Next problem. We have this right triangle, and we want to know what is the angle in degrees of the top angle. What we know is the length of the hypotenuse is 5 inches, and the length of the side opposite the angle we want to know is 2.5 inches. First step, SOHCAHTOA. We know the hypotenuse is 5 inches, and the side opposite the angle we are looking for is 2.5 inches. Thus, we need to use the sine. The sine of x is equal to the length of the opposite side divided by the hypotenuse. That gives us the sine of x is equal to 2.5 inches divided by 5 inches. Take 2.5 and divide it by 5 gives us 0.5 inches. Remember, to go back, we need to use the inverse sine, also known as the arc sine. Press the second key here, then press the sine button, which will now give us the inverse sine. Now enter 0.5 and close the parentheses. Press the enter button to give us the answer. And there is our answer, 30. 30 degrees is the measure of the top angle. Okay, that is it. That is how to use the sine, cosine, and tangent on the TI-84 plus CE graphing calculator. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to this channel.